All right, how's everyone doing? I'm Rich Cholenza. Thanks for tuning into the Rich Cholenza Show. WTF are you talking about? So what I want to call this podcast is teach your kids to think like a criminal. That does not mean I'm telling you to teach your kids to be a criminal. Quite the opposite. You know, I think, and I've discussed this before on my podcast, me growing up in the nightclub business at a very young age, you see a lot of things when you're very young up until your adulthood that a lot of people don't see at a young age. And the one thing I always talk about, and I actually just had this discussion with my daughters last night, or at least one of them, I should say. Or was it both of them? I think it was just one, the older one. And we were discussing how full of shit a lot of people really are. And she's by no means the most religious person. She's very cut and dry. She's really all about facts, which I like about her. No bullshit. So when I have a discussion with her, it's really interesting a lot of times because she doesn't say much, but when she does, she hits you right between the eyes. And what I discussed with her is the life that they led in Orlando, Florida, which was me kind of holding on or wanting to hold on to the innocence for my daughters as long as I could, because I kind of had the opposite of that effect. And it wasn't because of my parents. My mother was wonderful. She wanted to protect me like every other parent. But just being in the environment of a nightclub, bar, or all that, even when my mother got a divorce, she couldn't control that. And I wouldn't change that for anything. I actually loved being in the situation I was in as a young boy, all the way up into my teens. My father always treated me almost like as an equal, more or less like a younger brother. That's still the relationship we have. There's good and bad to that, like anything else. But I definitely loved it because my father was so brutally honest with me and took me in environments that were probably not appropriate for young kids. But he didn't look at it like that. He just thought it was a good time for him, and it was definitely a good time for me. Does it program you to be something, maybe a womanizer or somebody who, you know, all these type of things with women or an attitude? Sure. I'm not going to lie. That's basically who and what I become to a certain degree when I was younger. And that may come and go in my life. But back to my daughter's discussion with her holding on to the innocence and losing innocence and all these types of things. What I tried to do with my daughters was I tried to hold on to the innocence, but I was always very, I don't want to say I was very strict with them, because I was either the funnest guy in the room or the fun dad, the Mr. Mom kind of environment, or kind of brutal as far as, like, you're not going to, if you aggravate me, there's consequences. That doesn't mean physical or any of that stuff. It was very cut and dry. If you don't do this, this doesn't happen. And sometimes I may have been too tough on them, but then other times the life of luxury they had living, you know, in Florida, being able to not only hit all the beaches, being able to go to Disney year-round, Universal Studios, Wet n' Wild, you know, Blizzard Beach, Typhoon Lagoon, Epcot, all of them, we had year passes. So they lived a pretty incredible life, which was quite the opposite of my life. And I think one of the reasons I did what I did with my daughters is because maybe I wanted that life, but I realized I didn't. I loved the life I led in Chicago with my mother and father when I was younger, going through the 70s, 80s, and 90s. And I like those times. I wouldn't trade them for anything. And I think my daughters really loved the times they grew up in, because they kind of grew up in the 2000s, and now they're going into their, one's going to be 22, one's going to be 21. So they liked, you know, they like their times, right? I think they think they were last kind of the old timers with not having cell phones or iPads or all those distractions. So we would color if we went in restaurants, and it was like more one-on-one. And now they have two younger brothers, and I think they think they're a little, I don't want to say spoiled, but they live totally a different kind of lifestyle than they even did growing up when they were younger. But here's the thing now, going back to thinking like a criminal. And the one thing you learn on the streets, or I guess I was on the streets at a young age, and I had a lot of family members, uncles, cousins that were on the streets as well. Some dealt with gambling, some dealt with drugs, some were wonderful businessmen, some were athletes, some were, it was all over the place, which I loved. But I think if you grew up in the 70s at least, or maybe even before that, or even the 80s, you did a lot of things on the streets because there wasn't a lot to do at home. Let's face it, we were all about getting out of the house, I think, or at least my crowd was, about, going to do things. It wasn't about sitting at home. There was only a few channels on TV. Cable came out, but it really didn't have the channels like it does now. VHSs were there, but it was still more social. And I realized more than anything how full of shit people really are at a very young age, especially, and I discussed this with my daughter, when you see people in the bar nightclub environment at a young age too, you see them drinking, partying, doing drugs. Then all of a sudden you see them at church with their family, which I'm not against that to a certain degree. I mean, if you're honest about it and you're just having a good time now, if you're married and you're cheating or you're, whatever the case may be, you can complain about everybody. But a lot of people want to experience different things in their life. It does not make them a bad person, even if they're married or in a relationship. I mean, the whole world has kind of gone nuts to a certain degree, always pointing the finger, and it really pisses me off. But I was trying to teach my daughter yesterday that, and my mom used to really enforce this in me, and I really didn't think about it a lot because she's always about protection. But she lives in a frame of mind where she's almost scared, but stands up for herself, wants to be like very protective and make sure nothing's going to go wrong, locking all the doors, not basically kind of living in fear. But it makes sense because I'm not a female, and I really never understood that because I'm kind of a guy, and I think most guys, especially if they've gotten bigger or stronger, they kind of walk around like they just don't care. So if you're a female, especially a woman that's attractive when they're younger or older and they're a lot brittle, I guess you could say, and somebody makes the move on you, yeah, but I don't think that way. But I've been trying to install my mother's kind of advice, a lot of it, into my daughters because the truth is there's a lot of bad people out there. And when you're naive or even, I mean, really stupid at times, I think people don't realize how stupid they are a lot of times or how they. It's almost like they're setting themselves up to be taken advantage of. And it could be as simple as even their car, leaving cords in their car. So when their car gets broken into, their house, leaving the doors open, they get broken into. And also just putting themselves at the wrong place at the wrong time. So what I was trying to install in my daughter yesterday is kind of to look at things from a criminal's mind. That does not mean, again, I want her to be a criminal, but you sometimes have to realize for you to protect yourself, you have to think like somebody who's kind of a predator or that would come after you. Like, what would this person do to me? And I'm not going to allow them to do it, or I'm going to try to prevent it as much as possible. There's so many situations I think we've all ended up in our lives worth. I always talk about this actually in my podcast. 1 minute, 1 hour, one day can change your life for the better or for the worse. You can do something one day and your life is never the same. And that could be even getting in an accident, or that could be losing your temper and hurting someone. That could be getting drunk, hitting someone. That could be you getting a big job promotion. That could be you having a child, whatever the case may be. Thinking as a criminal, back to that, and being realistic about a lot of things in life that I think were very naive, and that's especially when it comes to family members and friends too. A lot of times, those are the ones that are going to take advantage of you. That actually almost are the ones that are going to hurt you the most. Usually the ones you're dating or married to, that as well. But if you can think differently than a lot of people, or at least, I should say, train your kids to a certain degree to think differently. I listen to these podcasts by these military guys, and it's amazing to hear how their mindset is once they're programmed to go to battle, or even when they're not in battle, is to protect themselves and the environment they're in. And I don't think a lot of this generation or younger people are attuned to that. I think they kind of walk around thinking they're always protected, or they have their phone, they can call 911, or maybe there's a camera on to protect me, or this or that. But the truth is, like, we put ourselves now probably more in danger than I think we even realize, even getting in an Uber or Lyft hypothetically, or my daughter getting one. Once she gets in that car, like, who the hell knows what can happen? Like, a guy could pull a gun out on her, or someone could do something, somebody could be in that car in the front seat leaning down. Who knows? Years ago, would you get in a car with a stranger? That wouldn't even be an option. But now those are things we do. We do a lot of things, I think, to a certain degree like that. But then on the other end, I do think we are much more protected, obviously, than when I grew up in the 70s and 80s, because, again, we didn't have cell phones. We didn't have cameras around everywhere. I think, to a certain degree, people behave differently now more than ever as well. And I also think more people are focusing on their phone than other people a lot of times. It's just a distraction. Is it a good or a bad one? I don't know. But as far as people like, you know, stalking you or all those type of things, I think a lot of people are more distracted than they really say they are. And here's the thing, too. I'm not even talking about like thinking as a criminal from the streets. I'm talking just in general, making sure you protect your, you know, your passwords, and you're kind of, when you meet new people, not to open up as much, maybe even on social media, not expose yourself as much as maybe you're exposing yourself. That doesn't mean like dirty clothes or dressing dirty or exposing yourself that way. I'm talking about letting people know where you are at all times, maybe even traveling sometimes. So you're giving a notification to everyone, hey, I'm out of town, come and rob my house. Or I'm going out and we're at this location and we're all doing shots and we're half in the bag. You know, you're kind of sending up signals to a lot of people, setting yourself up again. And I think we have to have these discussions with our kids to say, listen, the only one who's truly going to protect you is you. Because a lot of times we're by ourselves. And I mean, that goes for men, women, not only kids, everyone is, you know, not everyone, but a lot of times people are alone. That could be home alone. That could be just going to the grocery store, whatever the case may be. You have to be aware. You have to teach your kids to really, and I've talked about this before, teach your kids, if you know, how to fight if you can, or at least some type of self-defense, or how to keep their distance from certain people. Crowds, not getting caught up with strangers, doing stupid things. And again, especially if they're going to drink or smoke weed or whatever they're going to do. And don't think your kids, I've said this a million times, man, don't think your kids ain't going to fuck up. They are. No one is close to being perfect. And just like you probably screwed up numerous amount of times that you don't want to admit, they're going to screw up numerous amount of times. But we want to limit those. And we also want to make sure they understand that, you know, we're always there for them, but they have to surround themselves with the right type of people, hopefully. If they're surrounding themselves with a lot of assholes, right, a lot of people that are going to lead them to the wrong place at the wrong time or just doing shit that's hurting them, we have got to teach our kids to learn how to remove themselves from that environment or those people. And at the beginning, it may be very hard, but that's just the way it is. Now, a lot of times they may argue with you, whatever the case may be, but I think a lot of this programming needs to start when they're younger instead of waiting till they're younger or older. Because I think what's happening a lot with people is they wait when their kids are too old to start teaching them or programming them regarding certain things. They're like, okay, now that you're an adult, we could talk about this. Now you're an adult, I think you should look out for this, or you understand it's this way now. No, I really think if you started like 8, 9, 10, how to truly protect themselves, how to stay, how to learn, I don't care if it's martial arts, jujitsu, lift weights, whatever, get some strength, box, all these type of things, and they need to build the confidence in themselves when they're younger, also not to be taken advantage of. Again, they can, you know, you don't want them to get bullied, obviously, but you don't want them to be the bully, but you definitely, the younger you start showing them what life is really about, now that doesn't mean to scare the shit out of them and you got to send them to Scared Straight in some prison or start watching things online where they're, you know, deathly afraid that someone's going to be coming after them. But there really does need to be some type of programming when you're younger on how to teach your kids that there's a lot of bad people out there that want to do a lot of bad things to a lot of people, and you're not going to allow it. Not as a family and not individually. Because I think all of us, you know, I can't say all of us, but all of us are in certain surroundings and we become those surroundings. They could be really good, but a lot of them are really bad. Or, in my case, I was around a lot of good and some bad. And that's just the reality. And I think a lot of people fall in those categories, especially with families. They have, like, a lot of family members. You may have some family members that have wealth and some that are kind of on the streets. You may have some, it could be even siblings, some family members, you know, may do drugs. Some are workout freaks. Some, you know, they all kind of, you know, you need to teach your kids what's what on both of them. What really is the strengths and weaknesses? You know, I had a lot of family members that did drugs, alcohol, love them to death, still do. A lot are actually even very wealthy, smart. But what was funny is with a lot of them, they always had my best interest, a lot of those family members. They wanted me to go to college. They wanted me to educate myself. And then they were the type of people that like going to strip clubs. They like smoking weed or doing drugs and whatever the case may be, which is hysterical. But they knew how to balance it. And those people, a lot of times, are family members. They're going nowhere. That could be brothers, sister, cousins, aunts, uncles, whatever the case may be. But then again, you may have other family members, you know, that are either one or the other. They could be very religious, but the truth is they're kind of not as good as you think they are, right? They're kind of always preaching and kind of pretending they're something they're not. And, you know, the same goes for people that are very wealthy. Just because they're wealthy or you have wealthy family members does not make them always the best family members or the most, on the up. A lot of them may do a lot of things illegal. I've had family members, friends, even that I thought were, you know, white collar, great dudes, even lawyers, even my friends were married to certain, you know, lawyers, judges, the whole thing. And before you know it, they end up getting caught doing something illegal. They end up going to jail or things in that nature. Again, you want to protect your kids and teach them there's all these different types of people around them. And it's a lot of what you're seeing isn't real. It's not who they truly are. And I think that there's a fine line there to say, hey, we don't want to say all our family members, friends, colleagues, some of these people are good and these ones are bad, because I think there's good and bad in everyone. But the case I'm trying to make is make sure you teach them to protect themselves, okay? Because trust, most likely, if you have kids, they're going to get hurt in relationships. They're going to get hurt by friends. They're probably going to get ripped off here or there. Who knows what's going to happen? Taken advantage of. I think for the most part, we've all been in that situation in our lives. So it's most likely going to happen to our kids, but hopefully we can limit that. So I'm going to leave it at that. But you get a chance, you might want to check out my YouTube. What did I put up? I've been doing some more traveling. I went to a Amish restaurant with my girlfriend. I have no idea. I put it on YouTube. I have like over 500 views on it in like a day. I was like, what the hell? I never get this, because I went to in Sarasota. I love going to see the Amish. And we go to different Amish restaurants here in Sarasota. I go to some in Pennsylvania, the Midwest as well. And I like to go check out the Amish. They don't always talk to me, but I like to talk to them. I like their food. And I like the people. They're very, you know, I find it very interesting, all these different types of people. So I also been putting up some other videos up there as well, mainly fitness driven. So if you're interested in anything fitness, I'm going to be switching some things up soon. I'm on LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and I'm going to wrap it up there. But please protect your kids. It's your job. You know what I mean? And if you have nieces, nephews, little cousins, which I have as well, tons of them, I want them to become strong young men and women. And I want to start that at a young age. And I want to install strength in them, not only physically, but mental. All right? All right, I'm going to wrap it up there. Take care. And if you're traveling, safe travels.